welcome to the session. Tonight we're going to be talking about dreams and nightmares. I hope that this is going to offer you comfort and support as you go into sleep tonight. And I would also like to help you understand the phenomenon of dreams, why they happen, so that you can feel more empowered in overcoming any current issues regarding dreams and nightmares. So, if you are ready, we're going to get right into it. I have a tiny bit of cedar, dried cedar from the summer, and some garden sage, also dried from the summer. And let's see how they smell when mixed together. Clearing the air right now, clearing our space, creating a safe space, an open sanctuary for the healing work that's to come. Smells mostly like sage, but I've got no complaints. You're welcome to take some deep breaths now. With each breath, just get into your body. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out, moving tension. Breathe in. And out. Good. Because today's session is about nightmares primarily, why don't we light this up again? And continue this process of cleansing. It's important to cleanse the space and be with a soft intention as you go to sleep. So what you take with you as you go to sleep is what will manifest in sleep and after sleep. So let's take some extra time in just creating the safe space before you go to sleep. Sit into your body and set an intention for what you want to get out of this session and following the session from sleep. just going to move this around your head, over your head, above your shoulders. This is a really important area if we want to release tension and burdens from the day. As I do this, just drop your shoulders. Intentionally drop your shoulders. And relax your jaw. You can even move the jaw a little bit. And then let your lips part. Relax the jaw. Then bring your attention to your throat. Notice if there are any knots here. Breathe into it. Let it go. And then bring that attention to your chest. Notice if you have any tension here. Let's take some time breathing into the chest. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Now see if you can deepen your breathing. Bring that awareness down to the belly. Breathe with your belly as well. I have my hand over your belly. Feel into your belly now. Breathe in, belly expands. And out. Breathe into the belly. And out. Deep breath into the belly. And out. Combine your chest breathing with your belly breathing. Take a deep, full yogic breath. Breathe into the belly. Belly expands. Now fill your lungs up. Chest expands. All the way up to the clavicles. And then exhale. Equal inhale into the belly. And then chest. Equal exhale out the chest. Out the belly. One more time. Breathe into the belly. Then the chest. And then out the chest, out the belly. You're doing so great. Now that we've done that, just breathe comfortably. You're going to want to continue to take deep, deep breaths. Slow it down as well. You know, the slower your breathing gets, the slower your thoughts become, or the less there are of thoughts in your mind. So breathe in slowly. gently breathe in slowly. Exhale slowly. Breathe in. At this point, we've created a safe space, cleared our surroundings, set an intention, taken deep breaths to align the mind, body, and energy. We're currently in a really good place to fall asleep and rest. And now to take it a step further, I ask you to just be open to receiving this Reiki light. Allow this light to smoothen the edges of your unconscious psyche and help you process those overwhelming dreams and nightmares. Allow yourself to receive this light. Actually, I have a crystal as well that I would like you to hold on to during the session. I have here an obsidian. Obsidian is a truth-enhancing crystal. It shields against negativity and blocks psychic attacks. It's also excellent for grounding as well as absorbing negative energy. So I think this will be perfect for you. Now, to understand nightmares, we have to first understand dreams. And I have a really nice quote over here, a passage actually from Collected Works, Volume 10 by Carl Jung. He founded dreamwork, which is a practice that I do, and I often encourage my clients to do so as well. So here's a quote. Dreams are impartial, spontaneous products of the unconscious psyche, outside of the control of the will. They are pure nature. They show us the unvarnished, natural truth, and are therefore fitted, as nothing else is, to give us back an attitude that accords with our basic human nature when our consciousness has strayed too far from its foundations and run into an impasse. So dreams are the unconscious psyche's way of communicating to us important things that we are choosing to not acknowledge in awakened consciousness. Dreams tell us a lot about our shadow side, parts of us that we've chosen to repress and not acknowledge. And the unconscious psyche, given that it's a more primal, natural part of us, communicates in symbols and vivid imagery. Primarily through our senses, have you noticed? Through images, and most definitely through sensations and feeling. So even though on the surface, yes, dreams don't make sense, we can't be analytical about it. But when you look beneath the surface and decipher the metaphors, the symbols, you'd be surprised how much your dreams make sense. It always astounds me. I'll give you an example. There was a dream in which I was stuck on a subway and I just could not find the right stop. And ask around and nobody wanted to help me, and I was getting very frustrated. It was starting to turn into a nightmare because of how uncomfortable it was. And then I looked at the subway map, and as I was looking at the different stops, I noticed that they were all the names of the stops were all such, but they were written differently. I was trying to find the correct one where the spelling was correct. And I was having trouble with that. And then when I woke up and started journaling about this, I realized something interesting. The word such in Sanskrit means truth. And so in this dream, I was actually trying to find the correct route to the truth. And I was having trouble. I kept going the wrong way, and there were a lot of false truths. And that was giving me a lot of frustration. And this realization really astounded me because, well, I'm not well read in Sanskrit. I don't know much Sanskrit besides certain terms from yoga that I've learned. So it was fascinating to me that my subconscious wanted to communicate to me using a Sanskrit term. So that's an example of looking beneath the literalness of dreams and dissecting the metaphors. I invite you to journal about your nightmares in the morning. after you have them. And in that space, when the feeling is fresh, you can gather so much more about the dream and the meaning behind it. And important thing to notice, these metaphors are unique to you. These symbols are yours. Some are universal, but a lot aren't. So listen to yourself as you journal. You know the answer, because it's coming from you. And pay attention to the feeling in these dreams. Your dreams are trying to help you, even the nightmares. Your subconscious is simply trying to help you process and release negative, repressed energy. It's a good thing. It's a good thing to have intense dreams, because it means your body is really trying to push out this energy and help you move forward. It's just a matter of recognizing that, honoring the process, and not being attached to the fear of it. There's nothing to fear. And your unconscious psyche is simply trying to help you. Isn't that amazing? You don't even have to do any work. Your shadow is trying to help you. In your sleep, you're healing. So take that knowing with you, that it's all happening for you. Not to you, it's happening for you. And you're healing as you experience these dreams. Going to play the singing bowl, and I'd like to invite you to just get into a trance with your eyes closed and sink deeper and deeper into your body, feeling completely safe here. Allow yourself to drift off into sleep. Continue to let this light in, feel into the obsidian, and just drift off. Deep sleep, knowing that you will be protected and all of this is happening for you. You are healing. Your unconscious psyche is helping you, processing. Just allow yourself to flow into sleep. wish you a beautiful night. Sweet dreams. And I'll see you in the next.